Hello my dear students, I hope you all are fine. Today in this video, let's continue our chapter which is heat. This chapter is included in physics. Before starting the new topic which is temperature, let's recall some important points that we understood in the previous lectures. So let's get started first. So here comes the first thing. In the first video we understood that heat is a form of energy which makes any object hot or cold. If you provide heat to any object, then it will become hot, and if you remove some sort of heat from that, then it will become cold. Basically, heat energy is because of the molecule which is present in any object. You know very well that the smallest particle of any object is nothing but the molecule. The tiny particles of any object, any material is nothing but the molecule. Okay, so combining the molecules, you will going to get atoms, and combining the atom, you will going to get the particular material like wood, paper, rubber, plastic, any kind of material. Understood? Okay, so these atom and these molecules are continuously moving from one place to another place, and due to that motion the heat is being generated, and which makes the respected object hot or cold. The faster the movement of molecules, the more object will be hot, and the lower the movement of the molecules, the object will be cold. So like this way, the heat is a form of energy which makes any object hot or cold. Another example I will give you. Suppose you are performing any mechanical work. Suppose you want to grind any chutney inside the mixer grinder. So at that time you find out that the mechanical work is going on, the grinding process is going on, and after you switch off that process and you hold the mixer grinder jar, at that time you feel that the jar is quite hot or quite warm. Why so? Because at that time inside the grinder, the grinding process is going on. Due to that reason, the molecules are moving faster and faster because of the mechanical work. And due to that reason, the heat is being generated. Okay, same for suppose if you are charging your mobile phone. And after some time, if you hold your mobile phones, at that time it appears hot. Why so? This is the basic reason. So by performing mechanical work, by performing electrical work, or by performing any biochemical work, some sort of heat is being generated. Understood? Moving to the next, the second point is heat is a form of energy which transfers from hot object to cold object. Okay? This is the very important topic of our chapter, that is transfer of heat. Okay, and for the transfer of heat, the one condition is must, that is there must be some temperature difference between any two objects. If any temperature difference is there between two objects, so at that time heat will going to transfer from hot object to the cold object. When you hold ice cube in your hand, so at that time the temperature of the ice cube is lower than your body, and due to that reason, at that time your body is going to transfer the heat to the ice cube, and due to that reason, slowly and gradually the ice start melting in your hand. Okay, so from that activity we can conclude that heat is a form of energy which transfers from hot object to the cold object. Third point is hot and cold both are relative terms. In the last video lecture, we understood that we understood by one activity, and in that we took three vessels, and one is having chilled water, another is second is having tap water, and third one is having hot water. So by pouring our hand into A and C, so we find that the right hand is having cold water, means feels cold, and the left hand feels warmer, and both hand now if we keep inside the tap water, so the same temperature tap water our hand is going to feel, that this water is one hand will feel that this water is colder, and one hand will going to feel that this and is this water is quite warm. So that is nothing but the relative terms. Okay, the hot and cold both terms cannot work individually. They directly related with each other. This is the third point. Moving to the next, that is fourth point. The feeling of hot or cold is because of the flow of it. We just discuss in the second point only that when the temperature difference is there, so at that time heat is transferring from hot to the cold object, and due to that reason any respected object will feel hot or cold. So in short, whenever the temperature difference will be there, the transfer of heat will be there at any cost. Okay, so if you are holding any object and at that time you find that a respected object is hot, so at that time the temperature of your body is lesser than that object, and due to that reason the heat is transferring from that object to your body and hence it appear hot. Example, suppose I am taking a cup of tea in my hand, so at that time I find that this cup of tea is quite hot. So at that time what is happening actually, the difference, the temperature difference appears between your body and the cup of tea, and due to that reason the hot object means the cup of tea is transferring heat to our body. Up to when? Up to the temperature difference get equals. Okay, means chai ka and aapki body ka temperature jab tak equal nahi ho jata tab tak heat transfer process hoti rahegi. Okay, it is like if you are handshaking with another person and you find that respected person's hand is cold. Okay, and you will going to hold that hand for a while, suppose 10 seconds or 20 seconds. After some time, you cannot feel that respected person's hand is colder. Why so? Because the heat transfer process from your hand to that person's hand going on and on until the temperature difference, means your body temperature and his hand's body temperature gets equal. Understood? So this is the most important factor. Next thing, the opposite of this, that when the heat flows from our body to the object, we feel that the object is cold. Means suppose I am having ice cube in my hand. So at that time, the temperature of ice cube is very lesser compared to my body. And due to that reason, the heat is transferring from my hand to ice cube. And due to that reason, the ice gets melting and it appears cold. Understand? Up to when? Up to the temperature gets equal between the ice cube, or should I say the melted ice cube, and my body temperature. Understand? Now moving to the next, that is temperature. Temperature is the most important phenomenon when we are talking about heat energy. Why so? Because you can feel that respected object is hot or cold, but how much the object is hot or how much the object is cold, how can you decide by just feeling? And sometimes it happens that you might be burned or extremely chilled your hand by this, and you cannot hold everything in your hand. Okay, directly aap chai ke andar haath nahi duba sakte ho, elsewhere you will going to burn your hand. Okay, so for that, to identify that how much the object is hot or cold, we must have one phenomenon, or should I say a degree. Its name is temperature. Today's temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. What is this? This is the atmospheric temperature. Okay, and how can you cannot directly just feel it and identify that might be today's temperature is 25. No, you cannot get exact temperature by just a feeling. Okay, so with the help of temperature degree, we can identify that how much the object is hot or cold. Moving to the next, the point which we left in the last topic, which is our heat, that heat, SI unit, heat is a physical quantity, so unit must be there. So the SI unit means standard unit of heat is joule. Understood? So it is energy, and energy's unit is joule. Now the temperature, what is the temperature unit? Temperature unit is Kelvin. Yes, this is the name of one scientist. His name is Kelvin and he has invented this temperature phenomenon. And with respect, for providing respect and honor to this scientist, we have given the unit, temperature unit name as a Kelvin. But mostly we are not using Kelvin. Kelvin is mostly using inside the factory, laboratory purpose, etc. Whatever in general we are using, the temperature unit is degree Celsius, and in abroad country they are using degree Fahrenheit. Yes, Celsius and Fahrenheit both were scientists once, and they have also had done some important research related to the temperature. So that's why we have given honor by providing the name of the temperature unit. Okay, on their name, that is degree Celsius and degree Fahrenheit. We are mostly using degree Celsius in our India, in mostly in UK as well as in the USA, they are using degree Fahrenheit. Moving to the next, the device used to measure hotness of the body is called temperature. Now we must have to find out one device which will going to help us to find out that how much the object is hot or cold. So for that we have invented one device and its name is thermometer. Okay, and this thermometer will going to help us to identify the exact temperature of respected body or object. Okay, whenever you got fever, so at that time you feel that your body is quite warmer than the normal one, but how much fever you have, it is measured with the help of thermometer. So mostly doctors are keeping the thermometer under your tongue and wait for a while, and after some time they are remove the thermometer and check it out that how much the body temperature is, right? Remember, so this is the thermometer which will going to identify the temperature of the body. Okay, moving to the next. Today apart from learning, I bring some important facts, means encyclopedia, about the topic which is heat, and I hope it will going to find interest, quite interesting. So let me tell you the first one, that there are mainly two types of animals in the world. The first one is warm-blooded and second one is cold-blooded. Now you might have question that what is warm-blooded and what is cold-blooded. Okay, so let me tell you that warm-blooded animals means the animals which can regulate and maintain constant internal body temperature. Means they can maintain wherever they go, they can maintain their body temperature. Suppose right now you are living in India. Now the day after tomorrow you are in London, suppose. So at that time you know the climate of the London is quite cold compared to India. So slowly and gradually your body is going to adjust in that climate, okay, and maintaining the body internal body temperature according to that. So that is considered as a warm-blooded animals. Okay, means wherever they go, they can adjust their internal body temperature in any condition. So they are considered as a warm-blooded. Now who will going to include or which animals are included inside this warm-blooded animal category? So all the mammals, you know what is the meaning of mammals. So all the mammals are considered in warm-blooded animal, means which cannot give eggs. They are going to give birth to their child or to their offspring. So they are known as warm-blooded animals. So these mammals are included in warm-blooded animals like human beings, dogs, cats, cow, etc. So they are considered as a warm-blooded animals. Cold-blooded animals. Now cold-blooded animals means the animals which cannot regulate their internal body temperature with the change in environment. Means they cannot, if they shift to one place to another place which is having extremely different climatic condition, so they cannot adjust their internal body temperature, so they will going to categorize in cold-blooded animals. For example, snake is a reptile family animal, then lizard, then amphibians like frog. So they then crocodile, they are considered as a cold-blooded animals, means they cannot adjust at body temperature if certain climatic condition gets changed. Okay, so this is the difference between warm-blooded and cold-blooded animal. Okay, moving to the next, that mostly the cold-blooded animals can able to change their temperature according to surrounding. You know that reptiles as well as the amphibians, amphibians are mostly living inside the water also, and they can live on the land also. For just example, like frog. Okay, so they are setting their body temperature according to the surrounding. While the warm-blooded animals are having mostly fixed temperature, like between 35 to 40 degrees Celsius. This is the another difference. Okay, examples which I already told you, that is warm-blooded animals including all the mammals and birds, okay, and cold-blooded will include insects, fish, amphibians, reptiles, etc. Okay, so this is our first fact. Second fact is, as atoms move inside of an object, they create heat energy. We just discussed in the first slide that every material or every object is there on the earth, that is made up of the tiniest particle called molecules. Molecules will combine and make atoms, and atoms will combine and make respected object or any material. Okay, so these molecules are continuously moving from one place to another place. Okay, and the faster they move, the more heat energy they produce, and the slower they move, the less heat energy that has. Okay, moving to the next, that is, temperature is a measurement of how fast the atoms or molecules are moving within the object. Okay, so temperature is identified that how much the molecules are fast moving or slow moving in respected material. Okay, so temperature will provide that particular measurement. These both are almost relative terms, so I just completed in a very short explanation. Third interesting fact is, Earth stores its heat in oceans. You know very well that land gets heated faster compared to the water. Okay, if you don't know, then let me tell you that if you will take two vessels, in one you will going to put sand, and in another vessel if you feel same quantity of water and heat at same flame, so slowly and gradually you will going to identify that the sand gets heated faster compared to the water. Water is taking quite much time. So due to that reason, as you know that our earth 2/3% is covered with the water, the first thing. The second thing, that water is taking lots of time to getting heated. So due to that two reason, the earth is storing the heat into the oceans, or mainly I can say that seas and oceans, water bodies mainly. Understood? Last topic is, every object on the earth consists some amount of heat. You might think that ice cube do not have any sort of heat. No, it is not possible. Okay, whatever the cold object are there, whatever the heated object or warmer object or warmer living beings are available, everything has heat stored inside it. That is the universal truth. Okay, the more and lesser, more or less is another thing. Okay, but it is the quite that everything or every objects on the earth consists of some amount of heat. I hope you find quite interesting. Next time I will come with some interesting fact as well as the new topic of temperature. We are going to learn two types of thermometer. So we will going to continue it in next lecture. Whatever the queries are there, or if you find some more, if you want some more interesting information, you can ask me into the comment section. I will definitely going to reply you. Okay, and one more thing, that one student was there, his name is Achawa Mohammed Sarfaraz. He has answered he has guessed correct the chapter top chapter name. So I would like to appreciate him. Very good, Peter. Just keep it up, and I hope you will going to enjoy the learning. And I will request to another student also that please be please take participation in whatever the question I am asking to you, or whatever queries do you have, you can ask me into the comment section. I will always reply you. Okay, so next time I will come with the new topic. Till then, stay happy, have a nice day, bye.